Good afternoon, children. In the chapter Measures to Reduce Pollution, today we will discuss how we can save the environment and what are the steps to reduce pollution, what is Chipko movement, and what leads to Van Mahotsav. These are the key points we are going to discuss today in this video. Now, first, our earth is a very beautiful place, we know, children, and gradually we are destroying the scenery and the beautiness of the world. How? We are cutting down the trees and it leads to many various problems they are giving rise to. Like the earth is becoming warmer, there is volcanic eruptions, earthquake, flood, and many more things. Reduction in rainfall, losing of the soil, these are the primary effects where the plants are cut down. Now, we have the prime duty to save the environment. So children, please plant more and more trees in your surroundings. Try to increase the quantity of the plants. Now, give importance to afforestation. Afforestation means planting more and more trees and increasing the forest, the thickness of the forest. That means by increasing the forest, we are increasing the plants and we are saving the animals from being homeless. Because if you are cutting down the trees and we are reducing the forest, then many wild animals, they are missing their homes, they are becoming homeless. So we can stop this by planting more and more trees. The reduction in rainfall, it also leading to due to deforestation. We are cutting down the trees means deforestation. Due to the increase of these factors, our earth is becoming very warmer and many problems are giving rise to. So immediately we should take steps to measure and some steps to just overcome the problem. Now, we can keep our surroundings also clean. So how we can keep our surroundings clean? We can help our elders to keep the surroundings clean, not throwing garbages here and there, keep the roads clean, keeping the drainage system properly, not throwing any waste products in the water bodies. Garbages should be dumped in one place and it should be lit fire so that they are burning and then they are mixing up with the soil. We can reduce the pollution measures and we can follow some measures by which we can reduce the pollution. In this way, we can keep our surroundings clean, not only by planting more trees, but by following some measures by which we can keep our surroundings clean, like go green, then take some measures, some safety measures, or some follow some rules by which you can make your surroundings clean. Throw the garbages in the dustbin only, then make dustbins separate. That means with the vegetables peels should be thrown in one, dry garbages should be thrown in one, wrappers, those things should be thrown in one dustbin. So this way you are not mixing up the unwanted things in one place so that it can be dumped. Then there are more measures by which we can follow it. Now the small measures that we can take, that we can keep our parks, our roads, our neighborhood, these things we can keep, our houses we can keep it clean. From home only we can keep the environment clean. So this all about to how to keep the surroundings clean. Now what is Chipko movement? Now, many years ago, the people of Rajasthan, there is a small village in Rajasthan where people started this movement, that is called Chipko movement. Now, it is the movement to save the forest. It is the movement to save the forest. Actually, the word Chipko means to hug the trees and not allow to cut them. That means you are hugging the trees and you are not allowing them to cut down. So in this way, all common people of the villages, they came forward to save the forest and the trees. And this happened nearly 300 years ago, a place named the Khejarali village near Rajasthan, where people all came together forward to protect the trees and environment. Once, ruler of Maratha, Maharaja Abhay Singh, he went with his ministers and all the members to the place that is Khejarali village, and he wanted to cut down the trees and he wanted some trees for fuel and to make a new palace. But the villagers, they opposed and they protested and they didn't allow any one of them to cut down a single tree from there, and this led to the movement called Chipko movement. A woman named Amrita Devi and her three daughters, they came forward and they declared that they would rather cut their heads off, but they should save the trees. By listening to this, all other villagers came forward. Nearly 300 people, they sacrificed their lives in saving the trees. When the king came to know about this matter, he was very upset and he was very sad to know about the incident. And he ordered that now no more trees will be cut down and no more hunting of animals will be done in the village. So after that it was stopped. Now, what is Van Mahotsav? Van Mahotsav means the annual celebration of planting trees. It was started by Dr. K. M. Munshi in 1950, and he was the Minister of Agriculture. It is the annual festival where plants are planted, saplings are planted to become and grow up as big trees. Now, there are some special features or silent features of Van Mahotsav. So what are being done during this celebration of Van Mahotsav? Throughout the week, they celebrate, people celebrate Van Mahotsav week, and they plant saplings in different places, different seminars and workshops are being taken place. People who are interested in Van Mahotsav, they plant saplings in different colleges and schools, and awareness programs are being run to make people aware of the current environment and current situation of our earth. Later in 1973, modern Chipko movement started, where Gaura Devi, Sundalal Bahuguna, then Sudesh Devi, then many more activists, they took active participation in saving the life of the trees. And they took up many measures and they started awareness campaigning, awareness programs among the people to make the secured life of the plants. Now we have to take measures. How can we take steps to reduce the pollution? How we can reduce the pollution? Now we have to follow the three R's, that is reduce, reuse and recycle. Reuse, reduce and recycle. That means we have to think for the waste products. Then proper disposal of the waste. We should manage that the proper disposal should be there. Then planting more and more trees. We have to plant more and more trees so that the environment becomes green. Then we should use CNG gases in place of diesel and petrol. We should stop using burning of crackers so that there will be less air pollution. Then do not play loud music, then noise pollution can be avoided. Stop burning of garbages and proper using of the garbages, and stop burning that gas form and it makes the air pollution. Then properly discharge of sewage. Before discharging the sewage in the water bodies, it should be treated that whether the product should be thrown in the water bodies or first the discharge of the waste products like plastics, they should not be thrown in the water bodies because they are not going to mix with the soil or water. They are going to remain as it is they are. So before throwing plastic bags in the water bodies or in the drains, we should think twice that it will lead to the pollution. Then regular pollution checking of the vehicles should be done so that no smoke should come out from the vehicles. And we should not honk horns. Honking of horn should be totally banned in the silent zone areas like near hospitals, schools. No one should honk horns because it disturbs the environment. Nearing the in the silent zone area, they should be totally banned. Then breeding of mosquitoes can be stopped by disposal of the water properly, water, because somewhere the water body is locked and their breeding of mosquitoes lead to many waterborne diseases that also causes many health hazards. So we should take care of the roads properly, the drainage system properly, so that this way we can avoid the pollution. So thank you, children.